Hi friends, you have learnt quite a bit as regards fiber to fabrics in the previous classes, in 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. Here, we will try to add a little more to our knowledge. You all know we get wool. We get wool from the fleece of sheep. The fleece of the sheep get us wool. In the same way, we get silk. We get silk from the cocoons of silk moths. The world has a huge woolen industry. Australia is the leading country as regards wool is concerned. Then we have a big arena where silk moths are reared and silk is taken, silk fiber, and it is woven into yarn and then into clothes. That's also a very big industry. We, the Indians, have a lean to both these. We have woolen industry in our country. We have silk industry in our country. And these are the two areas where we can even plummet and expand our business like anything. There's lot of areas here in these two fields where we can move to much higher levels. It's not that we don't know these, but there's lot of scope to advance in these fields. So from that angle, let us see and study about these two industries. Today, in this video, let us concentrate on wool. Wool is derived from the hairy fibers of sheep, goat, yak, llama, alpaca, and camels. The picture is here. Wool is taken from all these different animals. But lot of premium is laid on the sheep's wool. Sheep's wool. Okay, next. Now, the process of selecting parents for obtaining special characters in the offsprings is termed selective breeding. When we say sheep or goats, don't be under the impression there's only one variety of sheep in the world. There are tens and dozens of varieties of sheep. Tens and dozens of varieties of silk moths. So what is selective breeding? The sheep have been there from a very long time on earth. But man, by virtue of science, has tried to improve the generic values of the sheep. How can I say that I procure more wool from the sheep I have? How can we build up new genera of sheep which can give us the best wool possible? More quantitatively we should be able to improve. Qualitatively too we should be able to improve on the kind of wool we get. So what should we do for this? You rear sheep, and even as you are going to get their offsprings, you get them selectively bred. You pick up a male from one breed, the female from another breed, keeping in view the various qualities they have, and you get them bread with each other. Now, the sheep you get will have qualities drawn from this breed as well as that breed. So research stations, research labs have been doing lot of experiments in this particular field. So what is the viewpoint here? We have to get better species of sheep that have high commercial value. We should be able to get the best wool possible. That kind of wool which we need. That kind of wool which can give us the best sweaters. That kind of wool which can get us the right kind of clothes. That kind of fibers which we can mix with other fibers and get variety of clothes. So here, the scope for research is very large. Lot of improvement has to take place. And as I said, already there are varieties of sheep in the world. So, children, as they go for higher studies, they may take the woolen industry, rearing sheep and getting wool. From the wool, getting the fiber. From the fiber, getting the cloth. These are all possible fields where we can spread ourselves and serve the world market. India has to think on these lines. So selective breeding you call. What is selective breeding? You select parents, get them crossed such that you get kids of better quality. Kids that can give you quality wool. And in quantity too, we should be able to get well. So qualitatively and quantitatively, you go for better kids. Keeping that in view, you cross the male and the female. Already a lot of research is going on and there is lot of scope too. So this is what is called as selective breeding. Remember well, this is a key part. As we do in plants, we do it in animals too. You know, cows and oxen, the cattle, they are interbred to get cows which give us a higher yield of milk. Even the nutrients in the milk should be of a higher value. This is what you call as selective breeding. The process of selecting parents for obtaining special characters in the offsprings is termed as selective breeding. Something you should know and try to collect more and more information about this from the internet. Yak wool. You know, these yaks are found in the Himalayan slopes. In areas covering the Himalayas, yaks. They can withstand the winters there very well. Yak wool is common in Tibet and Ladakh. Central government is paying a lot of attention to breeding of yaks. So the wool you get from yak, you call it as yak wool. It's not sheep wool, it's yak wool. Angora wool. It is obtained from Angora goats. See, goats too get us wool. Goats. There's a special kind of wool. Especially this Angora wool is very famous. So our PM keeps on repeating, in Ladakh we should give all the needed push to the breeding of Angora goats. It can become a big industry in Ladakh. Angora wool, Jammu and Kashmir. It is woven into fine pashmina shawls. its wool is taken, it is processed, and ultimately you get yarn. From the yarn, you make shawls. Shawls are a fashionable item too. It is an item that protects you from the winter's cold. And especially as you move around the world, you find shawls have a special significant role to play. It's an important dress item, shawls. Pashmina shawls are very costly. Go anywhere in the world, people who are rich, who can afford, they ask for Pashmina shawls. A Pashmina shawl may cost anything from 10,000 onwards, 10,000 rupees onwards, even up to 1 lakh if it's a bigger piece of cloth. Pashmina, especially in Hollywood and Bollywood, such areas, they always like to go for Pashmina clothes. You can try it on the internet and find out what all varieties of items can be procured in the market under the name the wool from the Angora goats or Pashmina variety of cloth items. Pashmina. Get it added to your vocabulary now. Pashmina. It can provide job to lots of youth in India. Lakhs and lakhs of youth can get themselves set well in the Pashmina shawls industry. Then coming to llama and alpaca. Llamas and alpacas. Here you have llama. We don't have llamas in our country. You have to go to South America to see llamas. Llamas are rich in wool. You can see llama. They are rich in wool. That wool is useful in the cloth industry again. Very famous. So llamas and alpacas. They are another animal. I'll show alpacas to you. From South America, they also yield wool. See what a big industry. How many animals did we get enrolled now in our list? We'll move to the next. Rearing and breeding of sheep. Shepherds rear herds of sheep. You call them as shepherds. Those who rear sheep for their meat as well as wool, they are called as shepherds. Shepherds rear herds of sheep. What for? Mainly for their wool. Sheep are herbivores. They eat grass, pulses, oil cakes. Only such food items they eat. So rearing of sheep is an art. It's an art. They don't just grow like that. You have to feed them well, keep them healthy, take care of herds of sheep, and they will be able to procure, get you quality wool. So what do you feed them? They are fed on all these primary aspects. Whether you go for it or not, we should know what things are. They are fed on a mixture of pulses. Pulses are rich in nutrients. Corn, jowar, oil cakes and minerals. What are oil cakes? From oil seeds you take out oil. Oil is extracted. What remains back is oil cake. In Kannada you call it as hindi. Hindi. Hindi the nantara ulidadde hindi. Hindi, hindi. Bijadinda enne tagada nantara ulidadde hindi. So after you extract all the oil from the oil seeds, what remains back is oil cake. Still, it has lot of nutrients in it. It's a very good food for animals that we domesticate. Say oil cakes and minerals. Just as we do need minerals for our healthy growth of our body, these animals too need minerals. Research is done. They know well what minerals are required by these animals for the healthy growth of wool and they have to be provided with that. The hills of Jammu and Kashmir. So where do we rear sheep in India? We start from Jammu and Kashmir. Angora goats, we spoke of them. Sheep, we spoke of sheep. Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim, plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and other states are also there. These are prominent states where it's a major occupation, are known for sheep rearing. Sheep rearing as well as goats. Goats too. The sheep are selectively bred. We already spoke of selective breeding. So what do they do? Even when they are crossed, the sheep are crossed, they mate. You should see that the right kind of sheep are chosen and they are made to get mated. One of the parents should be from a good breed. Need not be both. One of the two, father or mother, will have to be from a very good breed. Even when you cross cows and buffaloes, you take care. You always get your cow or buffalo mated with one of a very good breed. Then the cows you get will get give you plenty of milk. And they will be able to resist themselves against diseases very well. Because the best from both the parents come to the offspring. The best comes to the offspring, the calf. That is what we want. So this is what selective breeding is. If the breeding is within one particular species, some of the unwanted qualities may get built up. So always cross breeding is much better than internal breeding within one species. The sheep are selectively bred with one parent being a sheep of good breed. Remember, one, either the father or the mother should be of a very good breed. The other one can be ordinary. It works. Works wonders. Lot of experiments are done in this field. Sometimes these labs, special labs built up by the government, veterinary centers, they'll be having the right breeds there. So the farmers, they take their sheep there and get them bred there. There are different ways. The hair is shaved off for getting wool. See, from where do we get the wool? We get wool from the skin of the sheep. The wool grows on the skin of the sheep. So just as we shave, when your dad removes his beard or the hair from the face, he uses the razor and the hairs are removed. As the hairs get removed, the dead skin, one layer of dead skin too comes out. Dead skin. The dead skin has to get shaved off. That's why even as you take bath, you rub your body. You should massage and rub your body after applying soap. Otherwise, the dead skin will not come out. It has to get off, go away. Then you feel fresh. That's why we take bath every day and we keep rubbing our body after applying soap. The dead skin gets removed. So when you get the wool from the sheep, you have to shave its body. When you shave, machines are there. As you shave, the hair comes out. along with the hair, that's what you call as wool, one layer of skin too comes out. Because there you do not do it every day. It is once in a season. It's in winter. Winter, that there will be a lush growth of wool and you go for shaving them. Wool, abundant quality of wool, the shepherd will collect now. What is he going to do next? Yeah, we will see it next. See, these are the various stages. What is the first stage? Animals have to be shaved. Here too, different sheep, they have different qualities. Some goats and some sheep, they will have under hair growth. Under their body, there will be a lot of wool. Some may have right on their neck and this portion, and in the hind portion. From breed to breed, it differs. So don't be under the impression all sheep are the same. They differ. As per the variety, they differ. Shearing, this shearing of wool. Shaving, we call it as shearing. You take big scissors and in big industries, machines are there. If it is small scale sheep rearing, then you may have to cut with large scissors. Shearing, processing fibers into wool. Let's say shearing, that's the first job. The fleece of the sheep, fleece is unne. The fleece of the sheep along with the thin layer of skin is removed during hot weather. The weather has to be hot because the sheep too contract different diseases. You have to be careful. And in winter, it needs wool. It needs wool to keep the body warm. Why do they have wool? It is to keep their body warm. How is it they keep body warm with the wool they have? The wool that is thick all over the body traps air. It traps air. The air that is trapped in the wool that covers the body is a bad conductor of heat. It's a bad conductor of heat. So, from the body of the animal, heat is not lost to the air. So, the sheep wants to keep its body warm. It keeps it warm with the help of wool. That's why shearing is done on the onset of summer. We don't do it in winter. In summer, it wants to get it cast off. Animal gets helped if you remove its wool. Same thing when you wear a sweater. You wear a woolen sweater. See, cotton clothes may not help that much. If the temperature is too low, you need a good sweater then. Over all your clothes, you will put on a sweater. What does a sweater do? It has woolen yarn. Woven well. This yarn will trap air. Same thing, whatever I explained earlier. The woolen sweater, the yarn there, it has to be thick. The sweater has to be thick. And air is trapped. Air is a bad conductor of heat. So, from our body, heat is not lost because it's a bad conductor. Once you wear a sweater, you feel yourself very warm. Very warm. Because it's an extra skin that you have got now, which will protect you from the winter, from the cold winter. Okay. It is removed during the hot weather. The woolen fibers are processed to obtain woolen yarn. So, here you see how shearing is done. Here too you see shearing. Shearing. And there are factories where the sheep are just let in and the machines are there without harming the sheep, without harming the animal. They remove all the wool. So first step here is shearing. We will move to the next. Scurrying. This is the second step. Scurrying. The sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed. See, the sheep, they do not take bath every day. So a lot of dirt gets accumulated. Dirt. The skin will be producing grease. See, if you don't take bath, you find your skin oily. You don't like it. You want the skin to be dry. So you take bath. So the grease that is produced by the skin and the dust and dirt that gets trapped, accumulated in the wool, they have to be separated from wool. So what is to be done? Scurrying. This is the next step. Scurrying. You see here, they are washed. There are different ways of washing. They wash the wool well. Machines are there. So, a proper, absolutely good wash is given. And they remove the grease, dust and dirt from the wool. That's the second step. Easy to, very interesting. The entire process is very interesting and easy to learn. Third step now. It is called sorting. Shearing, scurrying, now sorting. You have different kinds of wool. The same sheep may give you two different kinds of wool. One is the one which is small, lesser in length, smaller in length, thin, nice fiber. The other one may be thick and long, depending on different parts of the body. Sometimes the undergrowth too will be there. So depending on all these, sorting has to be done. The fibers have to be sorted out. Again, machines are there. They sort out. Manually they do. With machines too they do. So this is sorting, another important step. Next, cleaning of burrs. I have shown you pashmina clothes here. See how bright they are, how beautiful they are. From angora goats we get wool, from angora goats, from there we get pashmina clothes. Pashmina clothes you get only from Jammu and Kashmir. It's a unique place in the world where these goats survive and you get the pashmina, yarn and clothes. Very costly. Here you see a Kashmiri sweater. These are costly. Then you have Nali carpets. Nali carpet, N-A-L-I, Nali carpets. They are also of high quality. Nali is the kind of sheep we come across now. Here in the fiber what you have got it washed, you have got it dried and it is ready for the next stage. Now here you have burrs, B-U-R-R. They are sticky knots. Sticky knots you find in the fibers. They have to be got removed. If you want quality wool, you have to get them removed. But sometimes they remain. You may not clear everything. That's why in sweaters, you find those burrs. If you have your sweater, if you do make a good observation, you get the burrs there. Here one burr, here one burr. And you'll be playing with them sometimes. Just finding how has this happened. This has happened because that burr has not been removed. Or while removing, they might have just left over. So depending on what kind of wool you need, burr removal becomes very important. So these are called burrs. This is cleaning of burrs. That's the fourth very important step. Next, now comes dyeing, D-Y-E-I-N-G. Know well the spelling here, D-Y-E-I-N-G, dyeing is putting colors. Now the wool which you have got from the animal, It has to be colored. You have to color it. What kind of color? How much of it? How bright should it be? Depending on what yarn you should get next and the cloth, you start coloring them. See, this is all coloring. They are dipping it in color solution. Then you have to get them dried up. See what bright colors, how well they absorb the colors. The blue, dark blue variety. Here the red variety. And here you get the yarn. Yarn is ready. Machines are there. Beautifully they take out the threads. Here too they are drying up. They are drying of different colors. So here dyeing, the fibers are dyed in various colors. This is the fifth very important step before you go for clothes, weaving clothes. We'll move to the next. Rolling. Now what is rolling? The fibers are straightened. Coloring is over, dyeing is over. Before you make the clothes, you have to straighten the fibers. They have to be combed, combing the fibers. See, the process is not that simple as you think. It has to be combed and rolled into yarn. It has to be made into yarn now. You have to roll it into yarn. Here you see, they have been rolled into yarn. The wool on the body of the sheep, it reaches this stage, covering all other intermediary stages one by one. See here, rolling, different stages here is a factory here, and ultimately you get the yarn, the beautiful colorful woolen yarn. We'll move to the next. So from yarn we get clothes, and clothes come out, and clothes are woven into they may be sweaters or shawls and all. Here we have to keep in mind one occupational hazard. Occupational hazard. What is occupational hazard? It may be a new word to you. Say somebody becomes an officer and he has to sit in his chair the whole day. Not 8 hours, maybe 10 hours or 11 hours or even 12 hours. He has to sit, attend meeting after meeting. He may develop backache after 1 or 2 years or 5 years. He works an officer, as an officer in an industry. Now he develops backache. Now what is this backache due to? It is because of the kind of occupation he has chosen. Now either he has to get treated for that, or he has to do exercise in the morning and evening, or he has to consult a doctor. To change his profession. Now such a hazard, such a problem, you find that upsets your health, is called as occupational hazard. Over a long period of time, if you stick on to a particular job and that job makes you suffer from the viewpoint of health, you call it as occupational hazard. See, sheep rearers often get infected by anthrax. Those who have taken up this job, we should know the problem too, anthrax. And you have vaccines for anthrax. If you take those vaccines, if you get treated well, you will be able to keep away. You have to take the needed steps to see that you are safe. You see, anthrax, it is also called as sorter's disease. Disease that the sorters get, because there will be dust emanating from the wool. What is emanating? It comes out. You have to move the yarn this side, that side, the wool, you have to pull it out. Lot of jobs are there. In spite of mechanization, you have a lot of jobs. The dust may enter in. The dust may have the anthrax germs in it. The anthrax germs may have a say on your health. So it is an occupational hazard. It is a fatal blood disease. Some may have immunity against that, some may not have immunity. But one should know. See, blisters appear. Then you may get pain in your legs. You may have problem with your blood circulation. Your health may get disturbed. That's all about anthrax. We will not go into details of it. Here you see. And here you see the anthrax germs. Anthrax germs. Once they get into your bloodstream, they cause havoc. So you have to take the needed precautionary measures. There are a lot of precautionary measures. No one need to get disturbed over it. But you have to get the medical help to see that you don't contract anthrax. There are lakhs and lakhs of people working in this industry. They are not afraid of it. You have to take the needed measures to see that you develop the immunity and you face anthrax germs. Now you see some breeds of Indian sheep. See, there are breeds, Nellore and Deccani. Now these are only for mutton, for the meat. No wool, you don't get wool. That's what I said. If you want to procure wool, you have to go for such sheep that give you wool. So you have to scientifically, you have to study it first. You have to study and you have to plan it out. If you want to take it up as a big industry, and then you have to undergo a training program in this industry, and then with the help of finance from the bank or that, this, you can plan out and go ahead on a big scale. See, Patanwadi, this is from Gujarat. These sheep are from Gujarat. You have Marwari, again Gujarat. Here, wool for Hosairi, army Hosairi. Then coarse wool, you get coarse wool. It's a bit rough and thick. Here it's a little bit smooth compared with this. Some are used for Hosairi. Then Nellore, Deccani we spoke of. Lohi, Punjab and Rajasthan. Good quality milk. You get very good quality milk the sheep give you. Besides wool. Then you have Rampur, Bushehr. UP and HP. Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. Brown colored fleece, not white fleece, bit towards brown, superior cloth. It is costly, it's superior, a better variety. Then you have Nali, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, superior carpet wool, you can make carpets. See, in all posh buildings, industries, houses, they have carpets. These carpets are made from wool. Then what a huge industry is it? Then Karwal. Say, Jammu and Kashmir. Here, undercoat is used for high quality woolen shawls. Undercoat, I said different kinds of wool may get produced by the same sheep. Some are longer, some are shorter. See, these are sorted out and used for different purposes. Again, it's a very good quality wool giver. So this about wool. Thank you.